Hello and welcome to the Business Roundup for this week. Thank you so much for joining us. We are talking about events happening in the world of business as well as the State of the Nation address, which is key in this week's debate, especially knowing that the President had concerns when it came to talking to citizens. Thank you so much once again. My name is Viola Kusasia and joining us today is Moses Mulondo. He is in the Business Department here at Vision Group and he's going to help us look at some of these issues in detail that took place this week. So thank you very much, Moses, for making time. Let's start off especially with the State of the Nation address, which is a highlight for this week's business events, where the President was concerned that the country had potential to grow, but it was really not growing. And he tasked the Ministry of Finance to find out some of the ways that Uganda can grow within a short period of time to increase its income. So let's talk about the areas that would help Uganda really move forward that fast, because he said a short period of time, even though there is no clear time frame. So what are some of those sectors that will help Uganda grow in that short time?
First of all, I want to agree with President Yoweri Museveni that given the enormous resources that we have as a country, we have potential to grow at a much higher rate than we are currently growing at. Because our current growth is about 5.5% and the projections is that next year the growth will be between 6% and 7%. But you see, even that growth has so many debates around it, because according to a World Bank report, 65% of Uganda's economic growth is concentrated in Greater Kampala here. So in the other regions of the country, it is not there. But even when you come to Greater Kampala where it is concentrated, again, it is in a few hands of multinational companies, factories owned by Indians and Chinese, and a few people connected to power. So even when they say that we are almost entering the middle income status, because the method they use is just getting the GDP of the country.
So some scholars and economists say that, for example, agriculture, which has got many people, still those people lack skills to be able to make use of agriculture. So they sum up the whole thing to be attributed to Ugandans lacking skills to be able to create lasting work that can be bought and can in turn grow the economy. So do you believe that Ugandans lack the skills, or is there something more that we can actually find out as the cause as why the economic growth is slow?
Of course, when it comes to agriculture, for the case of our government, it has been so much of lip service, because if you seriously want to get people out of subsistence farming, then you don't leave them with the rudimentary tools they are using of hoes. Government should have already supplied all sub-counties with tractors. Actually, all this money they are wasting on PTM to put in circles, they should have used that money to buy tractors, used that money for irrigation schemes, used that money for valley dams, those facilities for fertilizers and giving farmers inputs. That would greatly actually boost the levels of production, because the market for food is there globally, and currently, of course, our exports, most of our exports are from agricultural produce. But currently, as a country, before COVID-19, in 2019, our earnings from exports had reached $6.6 billion, but that is still a very small figure, because South Africa earns $130 billion from exports. Nigeria earns $70 billion from exports. Kenya earns $11 billion from exports. Tanzania earns $9.9 billion from exports. So you can see, Uganda, we have so much potential that we are yet to utilize.
And you mentioned about allocation of funds and also having to triple and even increase the amount of money that is allocated to these sectors, which have potential to grow Uganda. How about we look at accountability? We have had scandals of people, you know, hogging huge sums of money. So would you say that accountability also plays a huge role when it comes to, you know, not giving enough money to sectors, but also how that money is used? What is your comment on accountability as we close?
That's another good debate, by the way, because even after allocations, still that money, according to the studies, reports from the IGG and other government institutions, a big portion of it is stolen by the people who are in government through different ways, by the way, even with the connivance of the private sector.
All right, I know, Moses, that we have a lot to talk about when it comes to accountability on how government money is spent, but we do not have a lot of time now. That should be a discussion for the next time we are here. But thank you very much for having made time, and we hope to see you soon. And also you, thank you very much for watching. This is the Business Roundup happening every week. We are talking about the economy, potential for growth, and why it has been sluggish and what best can be done. So thank you very much for having me time to join us. I am Vaila Sasia. Back to the news.